Today we will discuss on powertrain NVH, means how the NVH is in works in a powertrain. First we'll see introduction to powertrain. What is a powertrain, how it is functions, and what are the different components in a powertrain and all those things. Next we will see, I think you can see my pointer. Next we will see the introduction to NVH. Further we will see what are the different applications. It's not only applicable in automobile industry, as well as it's applicable all other industries also. We'll see what are the applications, and further we will see how the NVH source and propagation in NVH. The critical thing is how the noise and how it is propagated. We'll see how the noise and propagation happening. And next we'll see the time and frequency, how the time and frequency are related and those things. And reduction techniques to the NVH. And we'll see a simple case study. That means a result. Further we'll see how the NVH, suppose you encounter a problem, how the NVH problem is further tackled, and what is the flow path, what is the process you have to follow to solve that NVH. Then further we will see what is the NVH which is applied in the industries. That means what are the processes they follow, and what are the analysis, what are the different analysis step they do. Okay, further after next is suppose if you encounter a noise and vibration problem during your development cycle and your analysis results show that there is a problem, then you have to fix the problem. That main purpose of an engineer or NVH engineer or any CA engineer is to fix this. That means diagnosis. Now we'll see how there are different methods available to fix that NVH problem. Then we'll see NVH director. This is one complete application available in Altair Optiwork, HyperWorks. We'll see how the basic things, how the Altair Optiworks, NVH director supports us in solving any NVH problem. Then we'll see what are the symptoms, like when you keep driving in a vehicle, you will first see what are the indications of NVH, like noise, vibrations, what are the different symptoms, initial symptoms we get. Further, because during the life of a vehicle, it keeps on increasing. We'll see what are the initial symptoms of the NVH. Further, we'll see full vehicle case study. We'll see one results, and next we'll see what are the experimental techniques. Like NVHC, noise and vibrations can also be done by experiment, not only by FEA techniques. We'll see simple things, how they do perform the NVH and noise and vibration analysis in an experiment. And what is the future? This is the thing, because current industry is changing due to a lot of innovation and those things. We'll see what is the future of the NVH. First, coming to introduction to powertrain. Powertrain is called as an heart of any automobile. See, if you consider an human being, heart is the most important thing. Doctors say that a person can be brain dead, but he can't be heart. He can't be without heart. That means what it means, like heart is the main functional part of any human being. Likewise, which is generating the source. Likewise, the powertrain is the major thing. Major and most single expensive component in the any powertrain system, which generates the purpose of it is to generate the power and propulsion, as you all know. How the power is transmitted, we will see. First, from the engine, the power is generated. It goes to transmission, and through the flywheel or drive shaft, it goes to differential and to all the four wheels. This is how the power is transmitted from the engine to the wheels. A drive line is nothing but the thing which moves on the wheels. Anything which is above the wheel is called drive line. Powertrain is nothing but which connects the engine and the drive line. This is basic introduction about the powertrain. Next, we'll see that you can see in the left image. There is the engine mounted at the front, and you can see the transmission system, and you can see the transfer case also here, and this is the drive shaft here, and this is the differential placed in the middle of the layout. And this is about basic things of our time. And there are now in current industry, like there are three different types of layout available. One is electric driven, hybrid driven, and engine driven. Here in electric driven, what happens is the battery is generates from electric energy, it is converted to mechanical energy, and the motor generators drives the wheels. In hybrid, what happens is like it is both battery using drives the motor, and as well as engine, which using a generator, it connects to inverter, where the electrical energy is finally converted to mechanical energy, which drives the wheels. Like both battery and engine drives the motor. In the current, whatever the normal engines vehicles we see, this is the scenario, engine driven. It is battery drives the motor, and finally the engine is directly driving the you can see that this is the green line is the mechanical power, how the mechanical power is transmitted. The engine directly drives the wheels, means battery and motor just helps us into start the vehicle. This is about the powertrain, and this is the simple layout. I think you all may be knowing, this is a simple layout how the any powertrain system assembly is like. First in it will be front mounted engine, or then it will be a clutch, then it will be a transmission system, it will be having a drive shaft with a U joint, and it is connected to a differential, which is placed at the rear of the engine. Here in the left bottom picture, you can see that there are different types of engine mounts. Engine can be mounted at the front of the engine, where this is front mounted engine, and where the engine and differential are at the same position, and it drives only the front of the wheels. The second type is rear mounted engine. Here the engine is mounted at the front only, but the differential is placed at the rear, where it drives the drives all the four wheels. In the third one is engine is mounted at the front only, but the differential is placed at the center of the drive line, where there is one central differential as well as rear differential. Here also that all the power generated from the engine is transmitted to all the four wheels. This is the different types of powertrain which is available in the current industry. Now, coming to the introduction to NVH. NVH is the three phenomena that noise, vibration, and harness are the three phenomena that occupant, that means a person in the vehicle, experiences while driving, or during idle condition. It is a very complex analysis, because the noise and vibration are both interconnected. That's why, because we call it as structural and acoustic interaction. It may be because of structural or acoustic. That's why this analysis results and are very complex. Noise is nothing but what you hear in the vehicle. That means it can be any sound, like from the engine exhaust or engine itself, or any loose component which is not connected properly. It starts to vibrate, and further we will see here the noise. Noise can be heard from inside the vehicle also, or outside the vehicle also. Next one is vibration. Vibration is what you feel and vision. What you feel is vibration is, it can be felt at your brakes or accelerator pedal, or it can be felt at your steering system, or it can be seen through sometimes the mirror starts vibrating. You cannot see the rear objects. That is the vibration what you see, usually see. Next is harness is nothing but the combination of both. Even a vehicle is driving on a rough road, because in automobile they test for different rough roads. Actually, they have different test roads. During that time, it is both noise as well as vibration present in the vehicle. Then noise and vibration, it is governed by two things basically. First thing is Government regulations. See, government has given each country will have some standard regulations. They have to maintain a certain sound levels or vibration levels in the vehicle. One is government regulations. Another is customer satisfaction. See, customer may be sometimes satisfied with the bit noise, okay, but like bad noise sometimes. It depends on the customer satisfaction also. In the this picture, you can see how the different categories of vehicles in the EU standards, means European standards, has given this. They follow this decibels sound noise. For the noise, for a car, it should be 74 decibels, less than 74 decibels. Minibus, it should be 76, and bus, it should be 78. Like this, they have some standards. Every country will have some standards. You can observe that all these things are below 80. These things. And coming to this sound is nothing but the pressure variations, means air, where which is around us, it starts vibrating, means that pressure, what is the outside pressure around us, it's variation in the pressure, it causes the noise to person. Okay, a vibration is nothing but the oscillations made by a body. It is subjected to a component or an object. So sound is part of air. Next is, you can see this graph. Here, the vibration and sound mostly dominates at from 20 to 200 hertz. And sound is usually what we hear is from 200 to what human can perceive here is 200 to 20 kilohertz with respect to the amplitude and frequency. And coming to the applications of NVH, NVH has wide range of applications in the automobile. See, what we are discussing only part of it, it is a powertrain. How the powertrain, because it is also one of the major thing, because powertrain is the source for the noise and vibration in an automobile. It is one of the major thing, but there are different departments in industries, like they check for the noise and vibration, heat and ventilation and all those things. How the transmission panel also is one of the department. Sound system, like in advanced things, advanced vehicles, like how the sound inside the sound systems inside the vehicle is also analyzed, and how the interiors acoustics at each point they analyze that how the acoustics behavior inside the vehicle, and it sometimes parking sensors also, how it behaves, exhaust and intake systems also they analyze for the NVH. Brakes wheel is also one of the major department where that brakes, you can see here, brakes produces, it can be good noise also, bad noise also sometimes. That's why they see the brake, it is complete one set of department. And door slam is nothing but how the door, when you close a door, you get noise. That is also analyzed in industries, how the, when you close a door and when you open the door, how the noise, because it shows the how the stiff is your car door. And outside noise, pass-by noise, nothing but the house outside noise. Wind noise, as you all know, it's related to aerodynamics and these things. Turbo noise, in advanced turbo engines, they see how the noise is generated by the turbo. It is more prone to this, like turbo noise in the NVH. See, other applications, NVH does not only include in automobile. It also includes in aerospace as well as heavy machinery industries, and it also includes, comes under consumable durables. Like in consumer, if you have a washing machine and it starts vibrating at heavy high speed and it's making noise, it's like very bad for the customer. Next, we'll see what is a noise, vibration, and harshness. Noise is nothing but the audible sound which is generated in the vehicle. Then further, it is a low frequency energy. It is not the high frequency. It is at the low frequency energy, which is propagates through a vehicle medium through the air, basically. Then vibrations are the basic characteristics of any vehicle or any component in the world. It is having basic characteristics of vibration. harshness, as I told earlier, it is the combination of both vibration and noise, which creates an uncomfortable feeling for an insider inside the vehicle. Harshness, it's experiences is a discomfort. It's also a discomfort experienced by the occupant when the vehicle contacts a single impact, like road irregularities. As I told, there are some test conditions they tested for the harshness also. During the speed bumps also, you feel that harshness inside the vehicle. You can see this picture here. There are different noise, which are different places where the noise can be generated. It can be at the brakes, rolling noise, and gear noise, and all those things. Then first we will see what are the sources. I think major of the sources is known. First we will see what are the major sources of the in the NVH. First, for one of the major source of noise or vibration in automobile is powertrain. Powertrain, like it is the major source because it has having lot of dynamic activity inside the engine combustion. It can be like intake combustion as well as piston flap noise and reciprocating due to the reciprocating of the crankshaft. And torsional vibration, torsional oscillation of the crankshaft. All those things can be like sources. Rotating masses of the piston. Piston is continuously rotating. That's why you can have piston rod. That all those things can be very noise creating vehicles. It can be like noise as well as vibration as well. And exhaust noise. Sometimes like muffler and this exhaust also creates, we have to test for that, how the exhaust air is smoothly exhausted. Because it may, if it turbulence is there, it will create exhaust noise also. And valve train, because it's also rotating, it will create a noise and varying frictional forces also. Accessories like different pumps, fan, all those things, belt will also create a noise. Drive shaft can also be creating a noise. Because why these sources are important? Because when you do analysis, you at least you should know what is the where is the source in a vehicle. Once some noise or vibration is generated, you should know what can be the sources. Then only you can tackle the problem and try to solve that. Or you can, if it is a development stage, you should know initially where my problem can come. Because in if you see that gearbox, in the gearbox also, if the tooths are not aligned properly, if they have eccentricity and all those things, they can create a noise as well as vibration. These are the major sources of the in the powertrain. Then we'll see, this is just table which indicates how the frequency and decibels noise, it is coming from the different engine activity. You can see that first combustion is having around 500 to 8,000 hertz frequency. That means that frequency it is oscillating or vibrating. And it is producing a noise of 84 decibels. It is usually seen in the large diesel engines. Piston flap also will provide around 2,000 to 8,000 hertz. It is also producing 83 decibels. It all depends on the speed of the engine. Piston flap on these things depends on the speed of the engine. The valve noise, valve it is opening and closing, it will also create a noise. It will be around lesser compared to the engine flap because of less mass. Then this will be around 500 to 2000 hertz. It is produces again compared to piston flap, it will be 80 decibels. It depends on the valve speed, how the valve, how much time the valve is opening and closing, all the fan speed also, fan noise. All these things, like you can have a, this is the table just indicates how the different noises are generated in a vehicle. You can see all those things are within 80, 85 dBA only, it is there.